Let's start with breaking news that's coming in. Now, according to Enforcement Directorate sources, the ED has not summoned Sharad Pawar. The probe will primarily first focus on the officials of the cooperative banks and promoters and directors of the sugar cooperative factories. Remember, this clarification comes after Sharad Pawar said that he would be visiting the Enforcement Directorate on the 27th of September at a press conference just a short while back. Now, we understand that sources say that the ED has not even summoned Sharad Pawar. So the question arises whether Sharad Pawar is going to go to the ED despite not receiving a summons. And let's shift focus to the big story that we're tracking. Now, thousands of chartered accountant aspirants have been protesting against the Institute of Chartered Accountants for the third day. The CA aspirants allege that there have been errors in checking their answer papers. The aspirants have been protesting at the branches of ICAI all across the country, demanding a provision for re-evaluation of their papers. Now, this is not the first time that such a thing has happened. Now, in 2017, the Staff Selection Committee combined graduate level 2017 examination was leaked and sparked off massive protests across the country. In fact, the result of that examination has still not been announced. Now, last year also, two CBSE question papers were leaked and 28 lakh students had to retake the exam. On the big story today, we're asking whether there is an urgent need for a more efficient exam system in the country. That, of course, is the big question. But first, let's look at the protests that have broken out here for 3 days. Now, today is the third day in a row that CA aspirants are protesting. Let's go across to Ayushman, who has been tracking these protests. Ayushman, obviously, the CA aspirants are extremely upset with the way things have been handled. If you can take us through first what's happening on ground.
Well, Abhi, right now we are standing outside the CA Institute of India in Delhi, where several aspirants all across from Delhi, they came here. They protested against this norm which is there in the clause 39.4, which says that the re-evaluation cannot happen, only the re-totaling will take place, and that is what is the main contention between the ICAI and the aspirants. The students have been protesting here for past 2 days. Today was the third day, and today the teachers have also joined. I am being joined by one of the teacher who will explain to us what is the bone of contention between ICAI and the students. Sir, briefly, if you can tell us what is the problem prevailing right now and what is the contention between the institute and the students.
Actually, kya sir, jaise kisi student ne apni copy de di, theek hai, exam de diya, uska exam jab check ho gaya tha, usne apni copy nikalwai aur usne copy mein kya mila usko ki usko na उसकी कॉपी में आंसर ठीक है, बट इंस्टीट्यूट ने उसको नंबर नहीं दिया. तो इंस्टीट्यूट में जो रूल रेगुलेशन 39.4 है, वो ये कहता है कि आपको रीचेकिंग का राइट नहीं है. सपोज करो आपने अपनी कॉपी निकलवाई, ठीक है, आपका आंसर पूरा इंस्टीट्यूट का आंसर तय लिया, बट एग्जामिनर ने गलत कॉपी चेक कर दिया, आपके 10 मार्क्स बनते तो उसने मार्क्स नहीं दिए, या MCQ में आपके गलत आंसर गलत चेक कर दिए, तो उसके बेस पे इंस्टीट्यूट कहता है कि हम इसे रीचेकिंग नहीं करेंगे, क्योंकि हमारा आर्टिकल 39.4 है वो मना करता है.
तो हम इसके अमेंडमेंट की बात कर
रहे हैं, हम लोग इसी की डिमांड कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि ये एक ह्यूमन राइट के खिलाफ, अगर आप देखेंगे ना, तो हम यही डिमांड कर रहे हैं कि जो बच्चा है, जो डिजर्व कैंडिडेट है, अगर आपने आंसर सही दिया तो आपकी कॉपी को रीचेकिंग का राइट मिले, ताकि आपको पूरे मार्क्स मिले आपके. ना
एज अ स्टूडेंट कितना मुश्किल है आपके लिए जब आप एग्जाम दे रहे हैं और यहाँ पे प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं, तीसरा दिन है, कल
काफी मुश्किल होता है हम लोगों के लिए, क्योंकि दोनों चीज मैनेज करना पड़ रहा है. अभी हम लोगों को अपना आने वाला एग्जाम है नवंबर में ही, जो 1 नवंबर से ये स्टार्ट होता है फाइनल का. हाँ. और हम लोग को प्रोटेस्ट भी करना पड़ रहा है, क्योंकि हमारे जो कॉपी है अच्छे से चेक नहीं होते हैं. अगर हम लोग MCQ लिखते हैं, ए में ए का आंसर ए लिखते हैं, सजेस्टेड में भी आंसर ए है, तो वहाँ पर ए को काट दिया जाता है कि नहीं, और जीरो मार्क्स अलॉट किया जाता है. और लेकिन एक्चुअली जो प्रॉब्लम आर्टिकल 39.4 जो है हमारा, वो एक आता है कि सिर्फ रीटोटलिंग करेंगे, कैरी फॉरवर्ड में अगर कोई इशू हुआ है वहाँ पे देखेंगे, लेकिन रीचेकिंग नहीं करेंगे. okay. लेकिन कोई हम लोग के पास राइट नहीं है जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ कि आर्टिकल 39.4.
Okay, so this is the main problem that is here, Avni, where the students say that even at the secondary school level or at the CBSE, you can get a revaluation of the paper, but at the CA level, you don't have that right, because as per the clause 39.4, the students say and the aspirants say that only the retotaling is allowed, but the re-evaluation is not there, and that is why these students have been protesting, and tomorrow again they are assembling here, they'll be protesting here. Avni, back to you.
Right. So, Ayushman, you know, the question really now is that so far, what has been the response from ICAI? I understand that so far there hasn't been any kind of written communication, but has anybody from there come out, reached out to the students as well? And secondly, have they accepted that there is, in fact, an issue in the way this checking was done in the first place?
Well, we did try to reach to ICAI authorities on to what they have to say about the protest which these students are conducting right now in front of the office, because they've been chanting slogans and they've been telling, they've been meeting, the delegation has been meeting. But what we got to know from the office is that at 4:30 there was a meeting, and it is expected by 5:30 they'll come out with a statement in which they'll clarify their position. For now, the students say that they're in past also, and for now also, they have been given verbal assurances as to this matter will be taken care of, but nothing so far has happened, Avni.
All right, Ayushman, stay with us. We'll come back to you and get in some more voices as well. But let's also first go across to Bharva Borana, who's a teacher, who's joining us on the phone line. Thank you so much for joining us. Your understanding of what's happened here and how justified are these demands about re-evaluation altogether?
Yes, ma'am. I'm a chartered accountant.
Yes.
And basically, I'm a professor. I'm teaching to the CA student.
Okay. All right.
Ma'am, actually, our demand is only a simple demand and one demand. We want the revaluation right.
Okay.
Like, you know that CA Institute law is made in 1949. CA Institute law is made. There is a one regulation, that is the 39-4.
Okay.
And as per the 39-4, like, if there is a law, you can only go for the retotaling. Like, there is a law of the retotaling, but
right.
We want the law of the rechecking, or you can say that the revaluation.
Right.
Suppose if any student is not satisfied with the checking of the paper, mm-hmm. and he thinks that he should be passed in the examination, or he thinks that there is a mistake in the checking, then ICAI is not ready. CA Institute is not ready to check that paper again. So that is our only demand, is to recheck the paper or revaluation the paper. And for that purpose, ma'am, you know that in cricket also there is a rule of the DRS, that is a decision review system.
Yes.
Like, suppose if any umpire made any mistake,
yes,
then he can refer that thing to the third umpire, and third umpire can give this decision. So whenever the copy checker, suppose a checker made the mistake in the book, and you know that, ma'am, last exam was happened in the May 2019, and in May 2019 various students find that there is a mistake in the multiple choice question also. Suppose if there is a multiple choice question and right answer is a B, and a student also written the B, then also examiner crossed that particular answer and he given the 0 marks to the student, and due to that, a student failed in the examination. We have the various case, and various students came to us, sir, there is a problem in the checking system. So now we requesting to ICAI, please amend that regulation. And they can amend, ma'am, they can amend, they can first pass in their council meeting, and after that they can recommend to the MCA, and if MCA do the amendment, then there will be the amendment and student will get the right of the revaluation.
Right.
And this is only our single right.
The right.
Single
so, Professor Borana, so the question now is, what has been the response of the ICAI so far? Because obviously this is not just about this particular exam. This is about changing the rules as they've existed, as you've explained how they've been existing for so many years without being updated at all. What has been the response of the ICAI to this overall demand of changing the rule?
Yes, ma'am. Yesterday they called us and they had the meeting with us. For the 5-minute meeting was there. We requested you should amend that particular thing. But they are asking for the time. They are saying that we need some time. We need the 2 month, 3 month and all that thing. They are saying this from last, ma'am, 1 year.
Okay.
From last 1 year we are doing that particular thing. And they are always saying that we will do something, but nothing has happened. Nothing happened. So we requested them that you should call the extraordinary meeting. They said that we need the 14 days meeting time and all that thing. So but there is a provision. They can call the extraordinary meeting for the purpose of the student. Ma'am, you know that a student is a pillar of this particular institution. And there are 8-9 lakh students in India, and many students are suffering from that.
Right.
The institute has the power. President has the power, he can call the extraordinary meeting and
yes,
he can pass that particular regulation. And today, ma'am, one of the central council members, member from institute, he participated in our protest. Like, he is the member of institute, he is from inside, and he participate in our protest. Like, he is also agree, like everyone is agree, there should be a fair and true view in the answer sheet.
Absolutely. Professor Borana, stay with us. Let me also go across to Gautam, who is a CA aspirant, who is joining us on the phone line as well. Gautam, thank you for joining us. What is your, your reaction to all of this? Obviously, you have been part of the protest and are demanding that this this rule itself be changed.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल मैडम, हमारी मांग है कि रीचेकिंग होनी चाहिए. हम लोग जो कॉपी लिखते हैं उसका मूल्यांकन सही नहीं किया जाता है. जो जो आंसर सही आता है उसको गलत किया जाता है, जीरो नंबर दे दिया जाता है, रैंडम बेसिस पर देखा जाता है कि जो उनका गलत नंबर है, गलत आंसर है, उसको भी सही कर दिया जाता है. इस बेसिस पर, रैंडम बेसिस पर किसी को पास किसी को फेल कर दिया जाता है. इस बेसिस सुविधा हम लोग को चाहिए.
तो ये गौतम, ये आपको आंसर शीट्स वापस मिलते हैं तब पता चलता है आपको कि ऐसे सारे मिस्टेक्स हुए इवैल्यूएशन में?
हाँ, बहुत सालों तक हमने तो यूं ही छोड़ दिया था, लेकिन अब हम लोग मंगवा रहे हैं आरटीआई के द्वारा 500 रुपए प्रति कॉपी देके, तो पता चलता है कि हमारा आंसर सही था लेकिन उसने गलत कर दिया है. हमें दो दो नंबर काट लिए गए हैं सब में. बहुत जो 6 नंबर के हैं सही लिखा गया है, फिर भी उसको बहुत कम नंबर दे के फेल कर दिया गया है.
तो अब आपकी आप 3 दिन से ये प्रोटेस्ट जारी रहा है, तो कब तक प्रोटेस्ट करते रहेंगे?
जब तक हमारी मांग पूरी नहीं होती है तब तक ये चलता रहेगा.
ओके, ऑलराइट. गौतम, हमारे से बात करने के लिए धन्यवाद. प्रोफेसर बुराना, इफ आई कैन जस्ट कम बैक टू यू हियर, इफ यू कैन एक्सप्लेन टू अस व्हाट गौतम वाज सेइंग, दैट एवरी ईयर दिस सीम्स टू बी एन इश्यू. यू नो, स्टूडेंट्स फाइल थ्रू एन आरटीआई, गेट देयर आंसर शीट्स बैक एंड देन रियलाइज दैट ऑल ऑफ दीज मिस्टेक्स हैव बीन मेड, व्हिच ऑब्वियसली इज एक्सट्रीमली अनफेयर इफ स्टूडेंट्स आर बीइंग डिडक्टेड मार्क्स फॉर करेक्ट आंसर्स. बट हाउ मेनी सच केसेस हैपन ऑन अ ईयरली बेसिस एंड हाउ मेनी आर affected this time round? Would you have any kind of an estimate?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Like, you know that every time, like, approx 10 to 12,000 students complain about that particular thing. Like, 10 to 12,000 students saying that they are not getting the expected marks.
And how many, if I could just interrupt you for a minute, 10 to 12,000 students of how many in total take the exam?
There will be approx, ma'am, 1 lakh student in the year, 1 lakh student like in the 6 months. So, in out of the 1 lakh student, like approx 10% the student is not satisfying with their marks.
Right.
So there is a 10% ratio, but ma'am, you know that like your student, he study for 10 hours or 12 hours in the CA course.
Yes.
And if he is not getting whatever he written, then obviously he is not satisfied with that particular thing. And many students, ma'am, they are 25 years or 26 years, 27 years, they are giving exam from last 6 years, 7 years. And many students are like, you know that we are not saying that you should pass the like non-talented person. You should pass the deserving candidate. If any person is deserve, you should pass that. And if, ma'am, you know that copy check ho raha hai, wo ek insaan kar raha hai. और उसकी वजह से कोई ह्यूमन एरर हो रहा है. सो वी जस्ट वांट दैट यू शुड गिव
द ऑप्शन टू रीइवैल्यूएट योर द आंसर शीट शुड बी देयर. बट प्रोफेसर बुराना, टेल मी दिस, यू नो, यू सेड दैट 10 टू 12,000 स्टूडेंट्स कंप्लेन ऑफ द मार्क्स नॉट बीइंग प्रॉपर और नॉट बीइंग सैटिस्फाइड विद द मार्क्स. हाउ मेनी पीपल एटलीस्ट दिस टाइम राउंड, इफ यू कैन टेल मी, हैव एक्चुअली गॉट इट एज एन एग्जांपल दैट देयर हैज बीन डिस्क्रेपेंसी इन देयर मार्किंग, their sheets have been marked, how many people have written through the RTI and got their answer sheets back?
Will be like a student in the number of thousand approx, there will be 8 to 10,000 students. They suffer this time from that evaluation system. And ma'am, we are, do you know that there is a CBSE, they are giving the right of the revaluation, CBSE in 10th standard as well as the 12th standard. Mumbai University is giving the right of the revaluation, Delhi University is giving, in foreign also like SEMA is giving the right of the revaluation. There are various courses, all university is giving the right of the revaluation. Suppose if you appeared in the any exam and if you're not satisfied with your marks, you just pay the fees, whatever, 500 200, and like they will recheck your book. So this is the just a ma'am, and it is a justified our demand. It's like it is a justified demand.
So when you put these examples of these answer books which are wrongly marked in front of the ICAI, showing them that this is the way it has been marked, this is obviously wrong and it's for everyone to see how it has been marked, what has been their response to that?
They are also agree with that. They are saying that, yes, this is wrong. But they don't have power to change that. Because they are saying that, as per the law of the CA Institute, as per the regulation, they can do only retotaling.
And they can check only that all questions are like, you know, that all questions are ticked marked or not. So suppose if all questions are ticked marked or cross, then they can't do anything, because they are saying that we are bounded by the law. And law is saying that you cannot re-evaluate the answer. Suppose right. if answer is B, an examiner mistakenly crossed that answer. And ultimately that answer is right. But they don't have the power. They are saying that we don't have the powers. Then we are like, you know, that we are asking to them to change the law. Because if there is a problem in the law, you should change the law.
Right.
That is a problem, ma'am.
Right. Right. Absolutely. All right. We've got an educationist, Poonam Batra, joining us on the phone line. Poonam Batra, thank you for joining us. Your reaction to all of this here, this seems absolutely unfair, you know, and very brazen, because there is proof here clearly, as we are showing you on our screens, the way there has been mismanagement and way the marking system, the way the sheets are being marked. And that has been put forth in front of the ICAI, but obviously there is no rule that allows for a re-evaluation, just a rechecking of the marks itself.
Yes, I think the problem lies in the fact that there is no provision for re-evaluation in a professional course like this. But the point is that if large number of students or candidates are feeling that there is an issue here, then there has to be a redressal mechanism to address the issue. We cannot dismiss the issue. But what the specific aspects are, we will have to uncover those.
Yes.
Because we cannot also assume what has gone wrong unless we are able to unpack what has happened. So I think certainly a redressal mechanism is in order.
Yes, and obviously at this point in time, considering what we're being told that this time around and every year there are 10 to 12,000 students, which approximately 10% of the total number of students who take the exam itself, and this being a highly competitive exam in the first place, are not satisfied. And many of them then through the RTI get hold of their answer sheets and actually see how they have been wrongly marked in so many cases. So when that kind of data, when that kind of proof is in front of the ICAI, then obviously it's something that perhaps they need to look at a little more closely and work on quickly to ensure that these students get the deserving marks.
I agree. If there is already some evidence, even if the evidence is not large scale, but good enough for us to make a case, that there is need to look at this and think about how these examinations are being evaluated, then I think there is absolutely a case that the students may have. Overall, I think there is a bit of a laid-back attitude towards evaluation, because evaluation in our country has become a very mechanical process, right from school itself. So I think it's also a question of the larger frame in which we look at evaluation.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, that was going to be my next question on a slightly more broader perspective, just stepping away from this alone. We've seen several protests break out, whether it was SSC in 2017, then post that last year we saw the CBSE paper leak and protests based because of that. The entire examination system, the entire process of evaluation of exams is something that perhaps needs a complete overhaul in the way it's done in our country.
Absolutely. And I think this is being driven by a large-scale assessment system that is also coming from an international discourse. And therefore, we need to examine how we should look at assessment in a society which doesn't have a level playing field for most students, whether they're writing a CA exam or whether they're writing a Class 12 exam. I think that itself needs examination. We cannot make it so mechanical that we assume that all students come with the same kind of preparation. They don't.
Yes, absolutely, Poonam Batra. Thank you so much for joining us with your perspective. I want to go back to Ayushman at this point. Ayushman, obviously here, you know, the kind of numbers that we're hearing is staggering, about 10% of students not being satisfied on a yearly basis. And so many of them, getting their hold of their answer sheets through the RTI and then finding out that their answers are actually right, but they've been unfairly marked as wrong. It's absolutely unfair and unjust.
Yes, Avni, in fact, we have also got one of the aspirants who came here to protest, and he's having the answer sheet in his hand, and we'll talk to know what he has to say. Kya batana chahte hain? Aap bata rahe the, kuch flaws hain isme.
Yeh 6 number ka question hai, aur isme
हमें लॉ पहले तो लॉ एक्सप्लेन करना है, उसके बाद में कंक्लूजन एक्सप्लेन करना है. हाँ. मैंने पूरा सेक्शन वाइज पूरा प्रोवाइजो वाइज जैसे कि इसकी कंडीशन है. हाँ. और जैसे इसके मैनर है उसके बाद में इसमें मैंने कंक्लूजन लिखा है. मगर इन्होंने सेक्शन को राइट का निशान तो लगा रखा है मगर उस पर आंसर नहीं दे रखा. खाली इन्होंने कंक्लूजन पे आंसर दे रखा है और ऐसा सिर्फ इस क्वेश्चन में नहीं, पूरी की पूरी आंसर शीट में ऐसे कर रखा है.
अच्छा, तो ये और इसकी रीवैल्यूएशन नहीं की जा सकती
है? ये इन्होंने रीटोटलिंग करी है, रीवैल्यूएशन नहीं करी.
और यही मेन कंटेंशन है,
यही मई है.
So this is the status of Avni. There are people who have their answer sheets but they don't want to come on camera. They say that there are evidences that the answer has been corrected but the marks hasn't been given, and since this paper cannot be re-evaluated there is only a provision of retotaling. So these students are up in the arms. They are protesting against ICAI. They want this clause 39.4 to go and an amendment to come in where they can re-evaluate their papers. Avni, back to you.
Yes, absolutely, Ayushman. That was, of course, one of the students there actually showing us his answer sheet and saying how it has been wrongly marked and wrongly evaluated. Let's, in fact, go back to Professor Burana, who's still with us on the phone line. Professor Burana, you know, of course, we just saw an example of what you were talking about. But now, really, the question is, what is it going to take for the ICAI to actually come out? You say that they've already accepted that there is a flaw in the system, that there are these issues that need to be corrected, that there are problems in the marking system. But what is it going to take for them to actually come out and make that change?
Ma'am, we already requested them and they should understand the pain of the student. They should call the immediately general meeting, like they should call the council meeting. They should amend that particular clause and give the right to the student. That is our only demand. And if they are like, you know, that if they conduct the council meeting and they just give the assurance to us that we passed from the council, now that will go to the Ministry of Corporate Affairs and Ministry of Corporate Affairs will make the amendment. Then we will, like, you know, that we will end our protest from tomorrow itself if tomorrow they call the meeting and they like amend that particular clause. That is our only demand. And ma'am, you know that we also demanded, we given two options, either amend this particular thing or checking should be 100% like machinery checking. And 100% syllabus should be the MCQ, that is multiple choice question and all. So they said that it is not possible to go for the 100% MCQs. Then we demanded that sir only give the revaluation right. And if any candidate is deserved that he should be passed. And if he written right, then you should check again. Like your examiner will check again. Whenever there is a revaluation, right, then obviously institute examiner will check that particular answer sheet again.
Right.
And if you think that student is not deserving, please fail that. We
right.
are not saying that you should pass the undeserving student.
Right.
Only deserved student should be passed. And
yes.
If ma'am, you know that if you and we both are the human being, we can make
yes.
the mistake.
So absolutely, Professor Burana. Completely point taken. Completely justified. Thank you so much for joining us to my guests on the phone line and Ayushman as well. Thanks for joining us with those details and getting us those voices from on ground. The question here continues to remain that there is enough proof, there is enough evidence. There are 10 to 12,000 students, or 10% of the number of students taking the CA exam, who complain of being wrongly marked every single year, and this year was no different. Why is the ICAI not quickly changing the rule to ensure that the marking is done fairly? That's a question that we continue to ask. And we've got breaking news that's coming in. A special Delhi court rejects a regular bail plea of Karnataka Congress leader DK Shivkumar in connection with a money laundering case. He's currently lodged in Tihar jail. Meenakshi joining us on the phone line. Meenakshi, if you can take us through the details.
Well, absolutely, Avni. This is a big setback for DK Shivkumar because remember, while the matter was being argued, we saw heavyweights like Abhishek Manu Singhvi and also former Attorney General of the government, Mukul Rohtagi, make a determined pitch for DK Shivkumar on two, three primary grounds. The first primary ground of all health grounds as to how he has been in poor health and he is somebody who is suffering from high BP and other related ailments. And second ground, Ami, was the fact that the purported inflation
right.
in his assets and wealth, as showcased by ET, was rebutted, saying that this was the wealth which had grown in natural force. However, as we speak, the bail plea stands dismissed and the arguments put forth by the enforcement directorate somewhere have found more resonance with the local court.
All right, Meenakshi, thanks so much for joining us with that quick update. And with that, it's a wrap on this edition of The Big Story. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned tomorrow now.